in part C, we're going to do a similar problem, but now it's pH of 3. So it's become acidic instead of basic, and we want to know what the molar solubility is. So we start off in a very similar fashion. We do an ICE table, okay? We put some of this salt into a solution. That solution doesn't have any calcium yet, but it tells me it's buffered at a pH of 3, so there is a hydroxide concentration that we can plug in here. How are we going to get that hydroxide concentration? Well, we know that the pH is 3. So the pOH must be 11. That makes sense. 14. These two add up together to give you 14. So then the OH minus concentration, which is what this is going to try to keep a steady value of, is going to be 10 to the minus 11. So we will put in here 1.0 times 10 to the minus 11. So some of this dissolves, and some of this is formed, and I'm going to make two of these. I'm going to assume that I still have some of this solid left, that I have got my S here, and remember, it is not just the starting concentration, it is buffered to this value. So no matter how much of this I add, it's not going to be allowed to change the concentration. So the E line stays at a pH of 3, which is this concentration of hydroxide. So now I'm ready to write my expression. I see students skip this step a lot once they start getting to the KSP problems, and I recommend that you don't skip this step, that you understand it's not the solubility squared, it is the hydroxide concentration at equilibrium that is squared. KSP is value given me as 2.2 times 10 to the minus 20. That is going to be equal to S times 1.0 times 10 to the 11 squared. So when you take this and you square it, I'll go ahead and write that line as well, it's going to be S times 1 times 10 to the minus 22. When you divide this into that value, you're going to get an S value of 220. Wow! All right, you'd have to dump a whole lot in to get this much to dissolve. I want you to think back where we talked about how pH affects the solubility of a salt if the anion is a weak base. That's what we have here. It's not even a weak base. If the anion is the is a strong base here, sorry, if the anion is a basic anion, then the pH affects it. And I told you that adding an acid will increase the solubility. So what did we have in the previous problem? We had it in basic solution. The solubility was 2 times 10 to the minus 10. Now we add it to an acid and we get the solubility up to 220. That is what you call increasing the solubility as you add an acid.